मोमेंट आई रिमेंबर द पावर ऑफ दिस डेटी एक्सपीरियंसिंग डेटी एज गॉड आई रिमेंबर सो मेनी स्टोरीज वन स्टोरी फ्रॉम माई ओन पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस ऑफकोर्स आई वुड हैव टोल्ड दिस स्टोरी मेनी टाइम बट इट्स ओके आई लव टू टेल दिस स्टोरी इट इज सच अ वंडरफुल स्टोरी आई वॉज ट्रैवलिंग इन गुजरात आई ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दैट एल्डरली लेडी एंड रेस्पेक्ट हर लाइक हाउ आई रिमेंबर्ड यस्टरडे स्वामी लक्ष्मण जू आई कैन से दिस लेडी श्योरली लिव्स इन द लिव्ड इन द सेम कॉन्शियसनेस ऑफ गोपिकास आर द कृष्णास अंगदेवतास द कृष्णास डिवाइन कंपेनियंस फॉर्चुनेटली आई हैड द opportunity to see this lady. I used to go from village to village. I'll walk easily. I was able to walk 60 km per day. Morning I'll start. And after all, healthy young man, what is there? Just 60 km. By evening, about the sunset time, I'll decide where to stay. In the nearest village, I'll decide to stay. Then after a few days, if I feel like starting, again I'll start. Gujarat is land of God. I was traveling and in a small village. I was going from Gandhinagar to the Somnath. That time only they were constructing the Akshardham temple. Constructing are almost completed. The first Akshardham, Bhagavan Swaminarayan's Akshardham, went and had darshan, then walked, wanted to go to Somnath, one of the Jyotirlinga, in between one village. One elderly lady, she invited me, Baba, come and stay in my house. It was a small hut. She was having one cow and a small patch of land in front of her hut. She'll grow something for her to eat, some greens and whatever little bit things needed for cooking. And this cow milk she'll go and sell in the market. And with that she'll bring some food and offer it to Krishna and she will also eat. She had a small Krishna. She's a great Krishna devotee. Had a small Krishna deity. And she'll offer to Krishna. And eat. This is a simple life. I can say her whole total property value will be less than $1,000. Her per day income may be maximum $2. $2 is per day income. And whole wealth, worth of the wealth is $1,000. That's all is her life. And but living very quiet, contented life. I stayed with her some, maybe week. I forgot the days because all I know is sunrise and sunset. That's all. No question of watch, no question of calendar. Nothing needs to be used. All I know is sunset and sunrise and sunset. I'll know the Amavasya and Purnima from the seeing the moon. Wonderful life. It's a life to be lived without remembering even the years. 1 week I stayed with her. Every night she will bring the food and keep it in front of that Krishna and she will start talking. That is one thing. And I can neither contain my laughter nor I can laugh because I will hurt her and she is giving after all food for me. I have to be a little polite. What to do? But she will sit and she will talk as if she is talking to somebody. She will sit casually and have a small fan. The hand fan, she will fan that Krishna deity and she will tell, all right, please eat. She will tell so many things in Gujarati. I don't understand so much, but I can understand few words because many Sanskrit words are there in Gujarati. So, because Sanskrit words are there, few words I can catch. She will be going on talking, maybe for half an hour or 1 hour. Then she will eat that food and lie down. Give me also little food. And after 1 week, I said, all right, ma, I am leaving. I am continuing my journey. She started crying. No, no, no. Why do you want to go? I will not ask you to work and all. Stay here. I will give you food. And why do you want to go? All those usual things. I said, no, no, I am a sadhu. I have to continue my journey. Sadhus are not supposed to stay more than 3 days or 4 days in any place. Traditionally. Because till the enlightenment, they should not stay because the attachment may start growing. And their continuous sadhana may stop. They may not start doing their spiritual practices. So till enlightenment happens, they cannot settle down in one place. I said, no, no, I'll continue. I have to go and have darshan of Somanath and continue my spiritual journey. She ran to the Krishna and she started telling, oh, tell him not to go. I'm so happy that he was here. You only should tell him that not to go. And she started speaking. Then within few seconds, the very funny thing, she stopped talking and wiped her tears and said, oh, you are telling he has to go. He is a sadhu, he has to go. Okay, okay. If you are telling the okay, then I'll not worry. I'll not cry. She consoled herself as if Krishna is talking back. This is too much. All these days, she was talking to Krishna, okay, I can put up with that. Anyhow, devotee, she has some love for it. Anyhow, she is doing whatever she wants. And after all, she is giving me food, I have to keep quiet. And it's okay. And Krishna talking back, or she acting as if Krishna talking back is too much. I was a kind of a, such a sharp intellect, logic, never had respect. Till the age of, from the age of 10 to, till enlightenment, I did not have respect for all these things where heart needs to be used. Because all my energy and time was spent in intellect, the knowledge. Did not give so much respect for the necessity of developing the heart. Anyhow, when I heard that she talking back about me going, the Krishna says, no, 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 it's okay. Don't bother. She is telling, oh, it's okay. Oh, you are telling that he should go. I should be consoling myself. All right, all right. That was little too much. I went near her and said, with my broken Hindi and Sanskrit. That time I used to use more words because there is no gap now. I forgot many of the Hindi words. Stopped using. I told, Mataji, you are praying to Krishna, that is okay. But what you are talking, as if he is talking back to you. This all illusion, you should come out of it. No, actually that is the, that is the way, because, see traditionally sadhus are respected more. Even we are addressed as Baba. Baba means father. So all grihis are like a one step lower. Householders are like one step lower. They are not respected in the Vedantic tradition much. So, I had that same, I am a sadhu. So I told, these are all illusion, you should come out of it. You should eat healthy food and stay healthy to come out of all this. And she was so innocent. She said, no, no, Baba, I am not lying. Don't you see, he is sitting and she just held my hand. I promise, I saw Krishna there. He was sitting there. Just a simple child. I tell you, with what intensity you see me now, I promise, at least deeper intensity than that, I have seen Krishna there. He was there. Just a small baby. As he was described in Bhagavata, with a small flute in the hand and putting his hand like this in the, on the face, very innocently, with a peacock feather, all the uncleaned hair and very dirty mouth, all that food was there on the mouth and unwiped, and just that small little baby, he was there. The shock was from the very root center. Understand? The shock was from the very Muladhara Chakra, from the root, my being was shaken. It is a, you can understand, I was, see, even if I had the small doubt she is a saintly lady, I wouldn't have went and told her, you should come out of all this illusion and you should stop doing all this foolishness, you should be very healthy. I would have never told that. Such a simple, unassuming, no external expressions of any saint or a divine being in her. A simple lady, village lady, maybe 70 or 80. Just by touch, she can give initiation. Understand, this is initiation. This is not just, she was able to transmit that experience into my system. It is not that when she held her hand, I was convinced Krishna is there. No, I saw clearly he was there. The shaking or shock was so much, it just fell at her feet. I can remember very clearly, after falling at the feet of the Kuppammal, my first inspiration and great teacher, her name is Vibhudananda Devi, the spiritual name, Swami Mata Vibhudananda Puri Devi. After falling at her feet, with that same reverence and respect, second person who I fell at the feet means only this lady. This lady only received my respect and reverence equivalent to the Kuppammal. I just fell at her feet and said, never ever call me as Baba. You are my Mata. Because as long as she was holding my hand, Krishna was there. I saw. The moment she took her hand out, it disappeared. I was again same old intellectual. It was a very deep, strong experience. The same respect which I had for my own teacher started having. After that, I never ever had doubt or disrespect about this Murti Puja or this worshipping the deity. Even if I go to somebody's house, I'll go to the puja room first and do the namaskar. Sometime my own photo also will be there. Even then, I'll not bother. First thing I'll do, show the camphor and do namaskar. You do not know in whose house who is staying. In whose house who is residing. You do not know. Never take deities for granted. We take deities for granted because it is available for sale. Never ever take deities for granted. When I fell at her feet, she was not able to understand. She said, Baba, 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 what are you doing? Actually, she stopped me and falling at her feet, and she was so respectful. Afterwards, I had small little chat with her before leaving. She was so innocent, she was thinking, even if she is living with Krishna, then such a small person like her can have darshan of divine and living with Krishna. She was thinking that all sadhus would have had vision and darshan and they are living divine life. I said, that shows your innocence. I know how many people are meditating for years to have the glimpse of the Lord. And here is a lady, she is living with him from morning till night. I have seen, she will lock that small hut and go for that selling the milk. There is nothing inside the hut to steal. Even if some thief comes, they will drop something out of love and the compassion and drop something inside and go back. There is nothing except 2-3 bricks for head and 2-3 gunny bag for lying down. But she will lock that room carefully and go. And I will ask her, why are you locking? No. If some dog comes and hurts Krishna, what to do? If Krishna, slowly, if he goes out and he gets hurt in the road, what to do? Such a deep feeling connected. I can see in her eyes how she sees the Krishna, how she looks at the Krishna, how the very vision is so beautiful, so clean. I never miss a chance to tell this story. Unfortunately, I tried my best. I was never able to get her photograph. After enlightenment, after the organization was created, I personally, specially sent people, tried to trace. We were able to locate that place, but she passed away. She was no more and we were never able to get her photograph. I wanted to get her photograph and put in all our temples as the ideal of Murti Puja. Person who lived with God through the deity worship. I wanted all our temples to have her photograph so that people will remember how an innocent village lady lived such a divine life of living with God. But unfortunately, we were not able to get photo. Because in India, the village's photography and all is unknown. It's not, never even heard, at least in 10 years ago and all. Anyhow, at least we can remember her and offer our respects.